Gerard Butler. The thing that has us very confused is how this absolute hunk of a man hasn't had the best of luck when it comes to relationships. So while we were picking up our slack jaws, we decided to do a deep dive into his love life and see if we could figure out why this handsome Scotsman can't seem to keep things steady with his on and off again girlfriend of 7 years. Is it because she isn't the one? Or are there some commitment issues lurking beneath the surface? In August of 2020, Gerard split from his girlfriend of 7 years, real estate developer Morgan Brown. The couple first sparked dating rumors after fans spotted them on a date in Malibu in 2014. It's no doubt that millions of other women were seething with jealousy because the actor had given his heart to someone else who would obviously get her own private show of him walking around with no shirt on. However, the relationship only lasted 2 years, and they split. In 2017, he sat down for an exclusive interview to announce that he was single and even confessed that within the next 5 years, he hoped to be married with kids. "I'd love to have one or two kids. It's about time," Gerard shared.
Is Gerard Butler, I don't know what you guys are going to ask, engaged? No, just another internet rumor.
Naturally, women lined up once again to donate several of their ovaries because who wouldn't want to be the one to bear Butler's children? However, he also added that it was difficult for him to date someone since he was quite busy with work. The actor also felt that he had no personal life at that point in time. Maybe all that kids and marriage talk was what Morgan needed to hear, because they got back together soon after the interview. They maintained a pretty low profile throughout their relationship, and things seemed to be going well for the pair. In 2019, they even made a very rare appearance at a red carpet event of the Angel Has Fallen film. Perhaps Gerard was finally taking his second chance with Morgan seriously, despite his busy schedule and all of his work. However, their reunion was yet again short-lived. In August of 2020, the couple had reportedly split for good. A source revealed that Butler's reluctance to settle down and commit to Morgan led to the breakup. It was strange to think that just a few years ago, the actor was hoping to be married with two kids in the near future, and suddenly he and Morgan were parting ways because he was reluctant to commit to her. Friends close to Gerard and Morgan also shared that they believed that the couple was better off as friends and were handling the split very maturely. Butler commented on his split from Brown, saying, "I went through a breakup during Corona, so I lost a loved one in a different way, and that's been very hard, much harder than I thought." Then just a few months later, the actor went on a fun getaway in Mexico with a gorgeous and mysterious brunette. It seemed that after two breakups that things just weren't meant to work out.
"I'm actually seeing somebody right now, but we're not married."
"Okay."
"You know, so I don't know, does that still make me a bachelor?"
"You're still a bachelor."
"Okay, so I'm still a bachelor."
"Yes."
And yet, in April of this year, the couple proved the world wrong again. It appeared that the pair had gotten back together after they were spotted grabbing lunch together in Malibu. If that didn't confirm that they were back together, then their next outing definitely did. On a sunny Sunday afternoon in Hollywood, they were caught during a very hot and heavy makeout session in a parking lot. As the reunited lovebirds locked lips, Gerard couldn't keep his hands off of Morgan after he loaded his bicycle onto a new track on the bumper of his black Land Rover. The couple is yet to confirm to the public that they're back together officially, but fans feel like they didn't need to after catching them mid-makeout. And this was the second time that they've been seen out together in just over half a year. So it's possible that they've gotten back together and resumed their low-key romance. However, Morgan isn't the only one to have stolen the actor's heart at one point. The actor's been involved with several gorgeous and talented women of Hollywood, such as Cameron Diaz, Jennifer Aniston, and Naomi Campbell. However, despite all of his efforts, he struggled to find his perfect partner. In a 2014 interview, the actor opened up about the difficulties in his love life, admitting, "I have not met the one princess yet. That doesn't mean I have not met a lot of princesses along the way, but not the one and only yet." However, he added that he might have actually met his princess and she may come back into his life at some point. He wasn't ready to rule out anything or anyone just yet. He also admitted that he's at fault for not being able to hold down a long-term relationship, and his career plays a large part in that too. He's explained that it's harder being in a relationship when you're an actor because he spends so much time traveling for work. 2 months here, 2 months there, and he knows that it makes it difficult to maintain a relationship when you don't get to see the woman you love as often as you want. Who wants to put up with that? But who says life has to be just one relationship? Maybe it's meant to have many short relationships. One of those many short relationships was with Jennifer Aniston back in 2009. Rumors about a relationship between the two fantastically good-looking actors sparked after the pair worked together in their film, The Bounty Hunter. While they kept things incredibly low-key, they reportedly dated for around a year. Unfortunately, things didn't work out, and they remained very close friends. In fact, during Aniston's divorce from Justin Theroux, the actress reached out to Butler for support. A close source to the pair even revealed that they were speaking nonstop during Jen's divorce, adding, "She isn't going to rush headlong into a new romance right away, but she's really touched Gerard is doing everything he can to console her. Whenever she's ready, there's no doubt he'll be at her side." For a moment, it seemed possible that Gerard and Jennifer might rekindle their romance. Unfortunately, they left many of us disappointed, and it never happened. The actor still holds Jennifer in high regards as he told Andy Cohen that she is a much better kisser than Angelina Jolie. Well, well, well. Isn't that interesting? We wonder what Brad Pitt would have to say about that. Aniston isn't the only high-profile celebrity linked with Gerard. In 2007, he was linked with his 300 co-star Rosario Dawn, and a year later, he was rumored to be dating Cameron Diaz. After spotting Cameron and Gerard together, an insider revealed that the couple was on a balcony watching the sunset. He had one arm around her waist and the other on the small of her back. She kept giggling and touching his chest to whisper in his ear. Things seemed to be going well for them too, and yet they didn't work out either. He was later linked with former Disney star Lindsay Lohan. The couple sparked relationship rumors after they were spotted kissing on a golf cart in Morocco. The pair spent much of the night dancing and flirting in the hotel's Sanctuary nightclub before eventually leaving the party together. Lindsay very proudly shared about her relationship, "He's hot, he's mine. I've got no ring on my finger, so I'm going to have lots of fun. This is the most romantic place in the world." As it turned out, Lindsay never got a ring for Gerard, and their fling was pretty short-lived too. Another one of his flings worth noting was the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills star Brandy Glanville, except this one wasn't nearly as romantic as watching the sunset off of a balcony or driving a golf cart through Morocco. During an interview with Andy Cohen, Gerard's love life came up. He told Andy Cohen that at the time of his fling with Brandy, he didn't know that she was on the Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. He added, "Anyway, we hung out, we had fun, and then I never saw her again."
Suddenly, I was walking down the street with the director, and these guys from
TMZ
come running down the street going, "Hey, what about you and Brandy Glanville?" And I'm like, "Who's Brandy Glanville?" Because I didn't even know her last name. So I'm like, "Who's Brandy Glanville?"
No, that don't count.
She got pretty upset.
Naturally, Brandy was furious, and she fired back at Gerard via her blog, Bicoastal Beauty Unfiltered. She wrote that she'd drawn inspiration from the Time's Up movement to respond to Butler, but she clarified that no sexual misconduct happened between her and the actor. She called out Gerard for acting embarrassed about his fling with her. She wrote, "Respect the women you invite into your bed and into your life, whether you know their last name or not, whether they're famous or not." While things with Morgan seem to be going smoothly, and very secretly, we hope that the actor finally gets his wishes of marriage with two kids. He may have the reputation as one of Hollywood's most notorious womanizers, but he's always been a romantic at heart. Perhaps his short flings are a result of him desperately searching for the right woman, or maybe he simply doesn't like being alone. Whatever the case may be, we hope that he finds the happy ending he wishes for. Don't forget to subscribe to Rumor Juice and hit that notification bell to stay updated with all our latest video uploads.